here with a YA book review for you of The Hand on the Wall by Maureen Johnson. This is the third book in the Truly Devious series. You can find the other reviews for the first book, which is called Truly Devious. It's got a purple cover. The second book, which is called The Vanishing Stare, and it kind of has like a reddish magenta cover. You can find both of those on this channel. I'll also try and put them in the end screen of this video in case you would like to check them out. I'm going to try and do this review without spoilers, so it may not be that long. First off, I really love this series. It is YA mystery and kind of made me re-fall in love with YA mystery. This and the Charlotte Holmes series, which you can find reviews for all four of those books on this channel as well, have really made me fall in love with YA mystery as a genre. So The Hand on the Wall is essentially, how do I want to explain it? So in the second book, Stevie Bell, let's start there. Stevie goes to Ellingham Academy, and it's kind of like an academy for the arts, essentially. And in the school, she wants to go there because there was an Ellingham kidnapping slash murder that happened in the 1930s. But Stevie's lifeline or plotline happens in the present day. And so she's been kind of obsessed with the case and trying to solve it, and she wants to be a detective. So this is how she gets accepted into Ellingham in the very first book. So the way the story is there's essentially two plot threads. There is the, every few chapters, it goes back to the 1930s, and then there's the majority of the book is set in the present day. So in the second book, The Vanishing Stare, the murderer is solved as to who committed the crime in the 1930s. However, at the same time, there are present day murders that happen in each of the first two books. And then there's no murder in this third book. There's just kind of like a cataclysmic event of sorts that happens. So in the second book, who did the murders slash kidnapping is solved. But in this book is where the motive is established as to, you know, why and how this person in the 1930s committed this crime. So essentially, the book opens with Stevie having said, "I solved this case," but she's kind of hesitant to really tell anybody. There's also the storyline of her kind of love interest with character David, whose father is a really powerful senator. There was some betrayal in the last book and then some weirdness. So that is also part of this book. And I'm happy to say that that's also resolved by the end. You know, I really don't know how else to do a review without giving away anything. I will say that all the plot lines are solved, both present day and the ones from the past. There is kind of a caveat in that is also addressed in the end. I think I solved it maybe like, I don't know, 40 pages before the reveal of the present day situation and who was the perpetrator there. So, you know, my tip for that is I tend to always gravitate towards, I used to be really into Agatha Christie like when I was like 14 years old. And so I tend to gravitate towards whoever is probably the seemingly least likely is often the person I think who is set up to have done it. That is my tip if you know, are curious as to who possibly did it. There was a great scene that was a couple of chapters long where Stevie does the classic, like, gathers all the suspects into the room and goes through the whole storyline. I've always been a fan of that as well. I loved Clue when I was really young, and Clue Jr. Not so much the movie, I'm talking about the board games. I've seen parts of the Clue movie. I may have seen it when I was really young, you know, and it probably was way over my head, so I don't really recall much of the movie at all, but it's just something that I liked to play. And like I said, I was really into, you know, Agatha Christie novels when I was in like 7th grade. So if you like mystery, then I think that you would like this series. If you've read the Charlotte Holmes books, I think you'd like this series. You can definitely expect in the future more YA mystery reviews on this channel. I plan on reading Stalking Jack the Ripper because I have all of those books. Hopefully they're not too gory. That's one of the things I liked about these is there's some disturbing things, but nothing like overly detailed and gruesome. I also plan on reading the Jacoby books, which I think are mystery. And I just got a series, which I'm not sure if it's YA or adult, called The Daughter of Sherlock Holmes. And that's ongoing. And I believe the Veronica Speedwell books are also mysteries. I only have 3 of those. Apparently, it's going to be a 7-book series. So I don't know if I'll start reading those or if I'm just going to get caught up to present day or if I just want to wait until all the books are out before I read those. So those are some of the series that are in this genre that I plan on reading, you know, in the future at some point, probably relatively soon for some of them. This series was great. I read it as it came out. I kind of wish that I would have binge read it, only because it was hard for me to like necessarily remember, because a lot of the books just like picked up where the previous one left off and my memory is not my strong point. So overall though, I love this series. I think I gave every book 5 stars, at the lowest 4, but I'm pretty sure I gave every book 5 stars. So the Truly Devious trilogy, The Hand on the Wall, these books, like I said, are by Maureen Johnson, and her picture is super fun in the back there. I know she's written some other books. I do have them. I think they're more like contemporary, which isn't really my jam, but I might look into them. And on a side note, which it doesn't have to do with this review, but I just saw Brittany Cavallaro, who wrote the Charlotte Holmes books, is writing a like historical fantasy series, and she's working on the first book, and it's called Muse. You know, I know titles can change, so I don't know if she's just in the drafting stage and if the publisher is gonna go along with that title, but I saw that and that's super exciting as well. Just because she has a very clean writing style in my opinion, and she's very good at making unlikable characters likable. Actually, I would say Maureen Johnson is really good at that too. So there's also a lot of diversity in this series. Well, maybe not a lot, but more than your average YA book. So that's also something to look into if you're interested in mystery and you're looking for something that's a little bit different. Then you should check out the Truly Devious series. In the meanwhile, happy reading and happy